Hey, good morning, everybody. This is the professor with Day Trading for Success. We are going to be trading the RV strategy today, starting at 10 o'clock in about 9 minutes. Please read this disclaimer. We are not licensed financial advisors, so make sure you pause and read that. So today, there's 20 of us up here on Zoom. We kept it to 20. We were getting a little bit of lag on the Zoom right now, so we're trying to figure that out. We'll be all trading 750 shares of Meta. I'll be calling the ball, quarterbacking. Basically, that means I'm going to call when to go in and get out, but all these traders make their own decisions, as I'm not licensed to tell them what to do. And we're going to be trading with the perfect one-minute layout. Most people are on Thinkorswim. We have some that are on different platforms. And then I'm going to go over what the RV strategy is for the next 8 minutes, and then we'll begin trading right at 10 o'clock, which is when we have found to be a half hour after market open. For those of you that are watching this that aren't in the U.S., a half hour after market opens for the New York Stock Exchange, we have found that that's an area where there's the most consolidation. And we're looking for stocks, large cap stocks, 25 billion market cap at least, 1 billion float at least, an ATR of 5-6 or above. We're looking for stocks that are just moving in a range, just moving right along. And on a freeway, down a freeway, like a recreational vehicle, changing lanes nice and slow and steady, that's what an RV stock is. So how do we figure out what that range is? Well, the first thing you do is you open up the daily chart and you look at the close of the previous day, which you probably can't see under my picture, but was 319.78. You look at the ATR, which is the bottom left of my screen here, over a 14-day period, $8.89. You divide that in half. What we're trying to do is we're trying to get the range. You can see here's an ATR high, average true range high and low. We're trying to get that $8 and whatever that was there, 87 cents, and we're trying to create a channel with the mean center. So you're subtracting half of it from the close to get the low and adding half of it from the close to get the high. That's your first range you start with. So that's what the stock typically, the range it moves within over a 14-day period. So you can pretty much consistently think it's going to stay in that range, or it's going to move out of it, and we would call that a trend, and it is moving up above the volume profile. But the range, this is a one-minute chart, so the range is way up here. So, and that's a lot about how you would set your risk management for in your trade plan, your daily trading plan, is you basically want to set your risk management to trade within these channels or within the large channel, knowing that you're pretty safe, that it's going to retrace. It's going to come back. I mean, look, I can't guarantee it, but that's what we found, that if you've made a mistake, you keep your share size low. It usually comes back and picks you up, you know, short or long. So now we create channels within those channels. How do we get these channels? Well, this is where the stock has turned around other times in the last 14 days. So 10 days. So we want to figure out in the last 10 days, where has the stock turned around? So through backtesting, we found that 10 days is a good time to figure that out. So here's your ATR range from here to here past 10 days back. So we're going to mark anything within that. We're not going to mark below that at all. We do that with Fibonacci levels, and we do that with a 4-hour. So I opened up a 4-hour chart, and you can see how I picked up different pivot points on a 4-hour. See how it's all over here? 4-hour different over here, too. I mean, it's hard to see when I'm not as big as I could be, but you know, we pick it up on the 4-hour, and then what that does is that creates channels. Now, that's areas where the stock has turned around before, so it stands to reason it's going to do it again. So what you're trying to do is you're going to be using scalping methods, of course, and you're going to see that being done live here, but we're also using these channels and other indicators to figure out, to give us a little bit of an edge as to when to turn around. Looks like it's making a big move up here, guys. So it could end up breaking through the ATR, which would be a different strategy. So Meta rated an 8.5 on the rating system that we have in Day Trading Volume 1, the book, or many videos that show how to get that, so look that up. But we rate the stocks that we pick. That's how we pick them. There's also a video that shows you, if you watch that video, tells you how to predict which way the overall market's going to go. Obviously, it's not for sure. These are just things that we use, and you know, it's more accurate than not. So every little thing you can possibly do to get an edge. So what are you looking at here? This is a one-minute chart. This is the scalping indicators. So all of our indicators, custom indicators that we have here, are free. You can get them by going to, it's either episode 82 or 83. It says right there, 10 free custom scripts. Also, if you just type in the scalping indicator on our channel, it'll come up, shows you how to use it. The DTS stands for Day Trading for Success. So these are all custom scripts. Normally, you pay an arm and a leg for with all these guys that you see doing commercials. None of them have this one because I did this one myself with the help of some of our subscribers and ChatGPT. But this is an amazing indicator you really need to have. You're going to see it in action here. The green is the buyers, the red is the sellers, the blue is the volume. It's telling you the percentage. You can literally see that this is momenting, this is trading up. It's telling you that it's winning out and to go up, although now it's starting to flip around. But yeah, you got to watch it close. But when you see the real momentum moving, you can make some quick money scalping. So that's a great indicator, and it's totally free. This is a 5 minute. You saw me open the day. This is a 4 hour. This is a 1 hour. This is a 15 minute, so I don't lose perspective when I'm trading on a 1 minute chart, which I will be trading on. And this is a 5 minute. So I don't think I showed you. So I set the Fibonacci on a 2 day, on a 5 minute chart, 2 days back. And it's got a new high, so that's not where the Fibonacci set. Here's where the Fibonacci set, right there. And then on a 10-day, right here. So there's the 10-day that it's set for here. So those are also all support and resistance lines that are here, right? So we're looking for those two. So, yeah. Guys, I'm going to be starting to trade in about 2 minutes, and I just see a trend up. So this might be just go long today if it breaks the ATR. So let's take a look. Now, you got to look at it as the strategy works. Every time it breaks through one of these pivot points or Fibonacci's, it's like it's being tethered. It's like it's being pulled down. Think about the candlesticks as being alive. And you have the volume profile here set as well. And it already broke through that, the volume profile set on intraday. There's the magnet, the point of control that it's constantly pulling it back toward. That's where most of the price action has happened. So you look at that like it's way extended and it needs to be very strong to keep making the move. Right now, the scalping indicators telling you that it's losing its way a little bit as it goes up. So let's just see if that's, nope, there it goes. So we have just over a minute to decide. This is a huge resistance if it were to break its range right here. I did take a little trade, as you can see earlier. But now this is the second time it's tapped here and pulled back a little. So I'm losing confidence in the move upward, guys, now. So let's just keep an eye on this. Everybody's here. Okay. We're all ready to go. Yeah. Everybody's ready to go. Somebody took a trade up there. That was a mistake. Yes. Okay. We're all starting at 10. Nobody wants FOMO. Sometimes people will just test their system, which is because you get a little lag when you first go in. So it's always good to do a short trade. A trade, not a trade that you're shorting. But so we have about 30 seconds, guys. And if it doesn't break through here again, I'm going to call it short for me anyway. That's what I'm going to do. I'm getting ready to go. So now if you want to follow the price action in case it doesn't reconcile, this is the number you're looking at to see what the price really is at, not the histogram. Although they seem to be very lined up. Right, guy, we got just a few seconds, guys. I'm going to go short. Wow. I'm going to go short there. I should have got it at 20. I got it at 11. It did break through it, so let's see if I made a mistake. Ugh, okay. Oh, well, that's a big move up, so I'm getting ready to reverse. How many of you went short? We're about half and half. Yeah, I know. I went short. It was calling for it to go long. I thought it was done here, so, it's coming back, so I might just try to get out for a lesser loss very quickly here. Let's just see. And oh, that's a big move down, so hang on. Let's see. So my position's 22, 3, 22, 11. Oh, okay. So there it goes. Now, this is the 9 moving average. This is the Fib. This might just be a small retracement. It's going to go right back up. So let's see if that's what's happening here. I'm getting ready to reverse. Okay, so there's a bunch of you still long. It's getting painful. All right, it's breaking through the 9. Wow, okay, here's the Fib. Get ready here. Yeah, I mean, it may retrace up there. There's some hanging on some longs here. That's an $800 down there. So that's way. I have mine set at $500 for any particular trade to get out of. I try to stick to that. Sometimes I don't because I don't want to give up. It seems like now this could be the beginning of a bigger retracement. Now, if you look at the 15-minute, we're red. Look at the 5-minute, we're red. So the perspective is red. Sometimes you can get lost in here. So we're definitely red here now. So now you could say that if you go halfway down this, we're in the 320 range. I don't want to lose what I got here. So I'm looking to see. Although I've got a nice cushion to ride this. So this is a good start for most of us. Okay, everybody's short now. Wow. So we have some reds up here today, which is fairly rare. But I can certainly see how it happened because that could be me. It could have broken way up here by the ATR up there already. So I think I got lucky there. So we're going down to, we've broken this 4 hour. It's really starting to respect us. Now, it did respect it earlier, so this could be it right here. So sellers won out here. The volume dropped as the buyers took over there, so that's a bad sign for it to go back up. See how the volume dropped as buyers hit the top? So this is where the action was, except for when we first were getting in. So right now, it's a decision time. Is it going to turn around or is it going to keep going down? Keep a close eye on the scalper's indicator. It's telling you what's happening here, and it's battling here. And the buyers are starting to win out. It's resting on this 4 hour. This is why you draw these pivot lines, guys. These are not, you know, some people say, oh, that's too much. Look, I can trade this. That's not too many lines. I mean, these are very, very helpful. Some people don't like all the lines, but I think they don't do this type of trading. So the RV strategy is a particular style of trading here. So it seems like it's rejected going down there. I would say I would flip if it goes through that fib. I would flip around and go the other way, 320, 133. Wow, what's happening here? It's not reconciling here. I don't know what the deal is there. So I'm looking at this. Hopefully it'll snap out of it. So I said, look here. Don't look at the histogram, and apparently don't look at the bid. The ask is keeping up. There it goes. Yeah, it just took a second. All right. I hate it when they blink out like that. Thinkorswim has a lot of great things. Sometimes a level two isn't too good. But it's good. It's okay because on the large caps you're not really reading this much. You're going to get filled no matter what, but you're going to get you're going to get some slippage. So now this is our next problem to watch, 320.66. So and then there's the VWAP down there. Yeah. So there's the VWAP, that red line, and look at it reject off that VWAP, which was at 320.58 roughly. It just rejected off of that, which is the true value of the stock at any given time. Wow. Is it going to keep going? I don't want to lose this. I kind of want to bank it and then play this game. I'm a little worried, but this is a large, nice. Wow. So it broke 320. What do we got? Okay, so it's heading right down toward the magnet. So that's 319.72. So look at that, because that's where it's going to want to go, right there. So that's the point of control or the magnet. It's pulling it down. See, it's just, this is set for intraday. So see how it's coming across and meeting us. So where are the arrows? So it's way down. Yeah, so you've got the arrows way down here to turn it around, or it will turn around at the magnet itself, which is the point of control. So to me, I would play it close to that. There's nothing on the 5 minute says it's turning around, other than we're getting very close to market open. Also was right around that point of control prices. This is right around a full retracement, which often means it's just going to go right back up. So I probably will bank it somewhere in here unless it turns around right here. And then I will reverse it and go the other way to see if it retraces back the other way. So let's see. But I'm not going to be as, I'm not going to wait for it to go the whole route or something. It just depends on what's going to happen here. So I see everybody is green right now, which is good to see. So let's not lose this, guys. This could be it. It's resting at this 4 hour. I'd say 320.66 would be for sure a turnaround, maybe halfway up this channel. Oh, there it goes. Okay, it's going back down toward the point of control. So at the point of control, I'm going to reverse no matter what. I'm going to take that reverse right there. So I banked 1,700, and I will just get right back out of it and reverse if it keeps going down. So let's see what happens here. But I banked the money, which is a good thing. So look at that. It's already back up. I could already have taken another 100 bucks. There'll probably be some slippage here, though. If I see another 100 something, I'm gonna snag that. Wow, it broke it. Watch out, guys. This could just, when that happens, sometimes it just shoots straight down. So for those of you that are long with me, be very careful right here. Now there, I did set a trend line today. And I don't normally do that, as you guys saw. So that could be some support, too. And that would hit that at around 319.30 if this keeps going down. But it's hovering on the Fib. We have a Fibonacci, and we have the point of control. And it's given it some serious support. So I didn't make a wrong call yet, anyway. So we're looking for a retrace up into this channel. This is why we make these channels. So this channel 72 up, we've got about a 60, just around a 60 cent channel here, a little bit less, a little bit more, I mean. So 62 cents, it looks like. So 63 cents. Wow, it's tempting just to snag that. It's not exactly. So look at the scalping indicator. I see it got cut off there. Buyers are winning out, but volume's much lower than where sellers were. So sellers still is, I would say, are still in control, even though this is happening. Big picture still red, so we can't lose perspective for that. And that's why I worry about not taking this money. I'm just kind of waiting for it to, if it drops off, I'm going to reverse and take a quick 300 here. Getting very close, guys, to, oh, wow, it hit the 9 on the way up there. Wow, then it went back down. When I watch you guys, I can't watch the price action. It's really, it's heading up toward the VWAP now. Can it break this channel? It has to. It's got a lot of resistance here, right? The 9, the VWAP, the 20, that's the 20 moving average. And this is a 4 hour right here. Then we have the 50 cents, which is right here. You've got to watch those. So that's a lot of work for that puppy to get through. So I'm not feeling strong about it, it moving. Oh, wow, it went reversed. Whoa, man, I should have reversed it. I missed it. Was that it? So it was just too much up there. I'll wait for one more surge and see. Because the buyers were higher than the sellers here. It was a pretty good battle on this. I'm not gonna get told twice though, for sure. So let's see. This is. I'm just gonna ride this push up as high as it can go, and then I'm gonna reverse. It seems to not be. I'm just going to take that. I'm reversed now. I am short. I got up to 19. I'm going to reverse again long. Yeah, I should have stayed short. Long is winning out here on this right now. I'm taking some baby scalps here, and the slippage has not been too bad, guys. We got a lot of people trading this. So I'm looking for a surge up. I like to stay in position if you haven't seen me trade on the large caps, because I always feel it's sometimes you get decision fatigue or you get delayed in making a decision when you get out and then you miss the move. So I know that with large caps, for the most part, they'll come back and catch me. If I guess wrong, it retraces. So I do set a 500 on this share size, max loss, just in case it's not going to retrace me and it's going to start to do a bigger trend. So I don't want to lose 500. So I might make the call sooner than losing 500, but that's in case I'm just having, I'm just having trouble admitting I'm wrong. And you've seen me do it. I don't get out when I should. I'll go 700, 800. And it's just like, and then of course that makes it so if you recover, unfortunately that's such a bad lesson, right? If it recovers after it goes past your stop loss. So my recommendation is follow your trading rules, follow your stop loss. Now the $1 million margin club, which is trading with me today, we pretty much go to the highest share size, the lowest account can handle, and that was 750, but most of these people could go several thousand shares, no problem with Meta. So it's a different range than what you guys might be used to, level of trading. Wow, it's just hovering here, guys. I'm playing long right now, but all the long-term data says short. So I'm going to try to get a jump on a scalp, anything over $100, and you'll see me reverse. I'm looking at the money. There's 93. I'm just trying to catch baby scalps here. It lost that one. There's 90. 52. Boy, it's really not. With 750 shares, guys, that's not much action. It's barely moving here. 90 again. 75. 45. Just back and forth down. Once I take my eye off the money, then I lose the perspective. I'm trying to look at the price action on level two right now. I want to get it up above here. I want to get it above 335. It's at 33. I want to get it up in here. It broke the 9. It's hitting against this 4 for resistance. So I'd like to see it get, there's 97.50. It hasn't been that high yet. Okay, I'm going to snag that. I reversed on that one. I'm going to reverse again. Oh, wow, I slipped like $40 that time. So I'm long again, 320.36. So if it's... not like I'm going to take that. God, did I slip there? 23. I thought I had more than that before. So I'm going the wrong way. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Oh, it broke that. Wow. So it's definitely making a move to retrace up. I'd like to get a dip here and go long. How's everybody doing? Wow, this is painful. 300, 307. Once you start getting excited about what you've been doing, you just call one wrong and then it all comes back to haunt you. Is it going to break 21? Oh my God, if it breaks 21, that is not good. So I might just buy out. I don't know about reversing again here. Let me just see this. So kick back off of 21. Can you give me a chance to reverse long here? Maybe a lesser loss. Get a bigger dip. 73. $63.90. 63 cents. One more dip. Give me another dip. 12. Oh, that was it. I'm going to buy out. I did a lesser loss there. I'm out of the position for a minute, guys. Just not liking the action here. So I think I was up to 2,400. So I lost a couple hundred bucks on that whole debacle. I'm going to try short again. I know you're saying, why did I just do that? It didn't make it to the top on two of these. And to me, that's a lack of confidence. So I'm looking at a short here. The Reds won, the short won out the last time. But I wish, guess I would have liked to get it a little higher than what I got my position here. I'd like to get it up here at 21. Should have waited for the 21, like right here. This is where I should have really gone short, right here. Let's see if it rejects off that again. Looks like it's going to. If it blows through it, then I'm in trouble. So now this is scalping. You can't get them right all the time, and I'm trying to read. It's just definitely traded in this channel here. Now it's kind of in this channel, but it's trying to break out to get up here between here and the fib. So, oh, it broke through. Wow. Then it came back. That was a fairly big, that was a 20 cent rejection. Now it's back up again. It does seem to be fighting to go long, not short. So I don't think this is going to be as good a day as yesterday, because it's just sort of slowed down. Of course, we had the open strategy yesterday, but meta was a couple, 3 days ago, I think. And I think I got like close to 4K. Definitely going to have to trade the power hour today, I think, to make my 5K. So there's a, now I'm looking for it to bounce off to 320.66. You guys, that's definitely not in first place anymore. Let's see if it can, if it can get down here. There's $75. 320.83, 320.72. Could it break that 66? Looks like it's heading down there. Going to break through that 4 hour? Or is it going to reverse? Let's see what we got here, guys. Yes. That's what we wanted to see. Getting back that money I lost a minute ago. How far is that puppy going to go down? To the 35? It might get support right here is where the problem is. So, and the 50 cent where it's hovering around. I'm going to take that. I'm reversing there. Wow. I'm going to reverse again. I'm looking for any green to reverse. I want to go back long. Yes, I'm going to go long there. Is it going to keep blowing through that? I got it long at 320.30. I thought that was a great position, but maybe not, because if it breaks through that, there's a long way down to the fib and the point of control. So got back what I lost and then some. Me over $100. I'll reverse again. Nope. Okay. Does look like it wants to go down. I probably should hammer down there. I'm at 30. This is calling that what the market maker will give me. So look at this center number. That's showing you what I'm going to get between the spread if I reverse or just sell. Wow, I'm going to reverse as it goes up. See how much slippage I got? That was a lot of slippage. So looking for a dip. I'm at 320.45 short. Yeah, I'm taking little ones, guys. It would have been probably better to take the longer move. One of the things I do when I get behind is I try to catch up with more scalps than maybe it's prudent, you know, because you do get slippage for every trade, and maybe wait for it to ride the channels the whole way is a better call. Breaks 3,000, I'll flip. That's close enough. Reverse on the long. So now I'm long at 320.28. Wow. We're just playing these little channels right here. I broke three. I don't know if I'm going to hold it the way I'm trading. It's a tad risky. Yeah, I dropped below three again. And I'm stopping sharp at 10:30 because I have a full day. Especially if I want to try to make the power hour later. Wow, I'm going to take that reverse there. See if it's going to break through all that stuff or not. I was looking at the money and wanted to stay above three. You guys are good. All right, so I'm back up in the lead here with a couple of people. We're right above, there's three of us over three right now. And that was some risky scalping I just did, and I could lose it fast if I don't change my ways, change my stripes. Although there's just nothing to call. It's in this channel. So I'm just trying to ride it up and down. Now it broke. It finally broke. Of course it broke. And as I got cocky and took my eye off the ball, I'm like in a bad way here. It's pulling back. This is a resistance here. This is the ceiling. This is the floor. So you watch it play off the ceilings and the floor. So it broke through the ceiling. It's getting tethered. Long term is still, well, the 5 minutes showing it red, but the 15 minutes starting to show it green, which is not good for me in a short position. So my perspective's a little off as I start to do these little scalps. There it goes. Trying to stay in the lead here. I'm going to reverse. I don't like it. I'm going to reverse back. I didn't like it. I reversed right back again. Didn't like the look of that. That was a good call. I think I probably lost 15 bucks or something, but now I'm in a better position. Is it going to break through 320? So look for 320 as the next resistance going down, guys. Those of you that are short, $320 even, the even dollar amount. It's heading back toward the magnet, and I was kind of hoping that. So everything's red now. 5 minute, 15 minute. Oh, that is tempted to take right there. 35. But look at it go. The strength of this move down. Sellers are right at the top. Second time. They've been going up with volume. So this is okay, so now it could turn around at the magnet. That's what happened before. Oh, I should have taken that. Oh, man. Really? Yeah, I missed that bounce. Yeah, I was kind of not thinking about, I wasn't looking as close as I should. I was thinking about stopping and what position it would be. What would the video look like with this money? Just taking my eye off the ball. Like to get to 4K. That would be really nice. I thought I wasn't going to break 3K a few minutes ago, and I could not if this keeps going the wrong way here. So, might just buy out of here. I don't like the I'm not sure about reversing this. Here we go. Just holding steady right at the magnet. Point of control. Here it goes again. It's making a run down there to get to that fib. That fib was at 319.77. That's where it turned around before. Volume picked up on the buyers last time on that one, so that's not good in this position. There it goes. It's into the magnet. Break it. Break through there. If it broke through there, it probably would fly way down. It'd probably break the fib. It's always a battle going on between the buyers and the sellers. Going to be doing a video, guys, besides hopefully a swing next week. I want to do a video for you at the end of this week that is showing you how to draw support and resistance lines for the various strategies, because I know there's been some, it hasn't been enough clarity on that as they ever evolving. So I'm going to go ahead and draw them for the RV strategy, for the escalator strategy, and for the open strategy. They're all a little bit different. And then on that video, I'll go over the rating systems for each of them a little bit more. So that'll be a good video. I won't be trading on it, but look at that. Wow. I'm going to reverse there. 38. Don't take it away from me. I'm past my time right now. I'm a minute past. I jinxed me. I got a 319.59. My goal is basically to get to over 4K right now. That's my goal without slipping. That's, so I'm going to stay in another minute or two to try to accomplish that. So let's see if that happens. Get back up, back over 320. Can we get back over 320? See, it just trades in this range. It trades in this range, guys. That's the thing. You can just count on it trading in the range. It's just trading in this range in here. And then you're using these support and resistance. Oh, man. Every time I stop looking, I just, I'm not sure I would have got out of the position anyway. But here's your ATR high. Here's your ATR low. We're in these channels. There's been no huge moves. And you're able to scalp out a living in here, even with 50 shares, 100 shares. Before you know it, you have a couple, $200, $300, $400 a day without risking a real lot. You just set a trading plan and stick to it. It's like, I'm going to lose $25 max per trade or $50, whatever it might, $10, whatever it might be. Stick to it, get back in. You do three bad calls in a row, maybe it's not your day, get out. I used to did three bad calls in a row, I would get out. And then if I had like a bad week or two or a couple of weeks, I would go into trader rehab. I would, whoa. Come on. Did I just break 4,000? I can't remember if I saw it. I looked here and not here, and I couldn't see if that broke 4,000. It is about to break. Oh, I got it. I'm going to keep that. I'm keeping the four. And it's probably going to keep going up if you guys are in the position. But I just, I met my goal, and I want to jinx it. It's past my time, so we're going to call. There's, overtrading is bad. Remember that. Set your times. You're going to trade, and then stick to it. And hopefully you're green when the time's up, but it doesn't get any better if you're red and the time's up. It usually gets worse. Something's gone wrong. I'm going to finish the train of thought I was on. I will be doing that video with a different, how to draw general support and resistance. I'll probably hit trend lines a bit too, for each of the different strategies coming up. So that should be a good one to get. And then I was talking about, three bad trades, get out. Stick to your trading plan. And then remember in the consolidation, guys, so let's just get to today. So here's today. So here it went up out of its zone and it's right back here. So let's just say you made a bad call and you went long right here. Now, depending on your stop loss, what your overall trading plan is before channels, you know, that was a bad example. Let's just say right here. say right here. This is pretty far to try to make this to come back and recover. If you were long right here, I would get out probably when it broke the fib, to be honest with you. So I was saying a bad example. But more along what I was saying, all in here, if you'd call it either one of those, these are retracing back to your position on the 5 minute. And you look at the 1 minute. So this is the grid lines that show me when the 5 minutes are up. And then this is the top of the volume profile, this red and green. So these are things you're going to want to know. You want to know when 5 minute traders are, I mean, you can look at your clock, but you can just see here on the 1 minute, you can just see this is 9:42 all the way up to 10:30. Look at the consolidate, look at the swale up and down, up and down, up and down. Other than that one big swale, you started way back here, it's all being recovered. So if you made a bad call, it's just all being recovered. And it does that. These large caps do that throughout the day. But set your parameters within the channel. And it's just, you know, I don't want to say it's easy, but look at these. Like if this was your channel from this fib down to this fib, it's in that channel. You know, it just left it a little bit up there. But it's in that channel still. And then you can tighten it. It looks like it really respected this 4 hours. So you pull your channel down from here to the fib. And you just ride a little bit longer. You know, this is probably going to come back up to that fib. It's just going to keep doing the same thing all day long. So, and that's generally how these large caps operate. So I did break over four, which was great. Listen, guys, thanks for watching. I will see you soon. Be careful out there and stay green. Thanks.